misers and miseries of the world, it gives me great pleasure to invite you here, to welcome you here to this first and only international conference of misers. I say only because we are too miserly to have a second conference. We were too miserly to have the first one also, but since some misers have showed up, we are happy to conduct these proceedings in the presence of these some misers. Oh boy, are they some misers. The rest, there were several thousand of them, did not attend the function because they were too miserly to spend 10 cents on the bus fare. As a matter of fact, they were willing to spend the 10 cents on the bus fare, but this time their neighbors refused to lend it to them. We are proud of the fact that all the members of our miserly association are multi-billionaires, not millionaires, but billionaires, and that they are so miserly that they will not even take out 10 cents for the bus fare to attend this conference. So this conference is for primarily for the dissolution of this conference. We could not send them the travel expenses because we are too miserly to do that. See, one good turn deserves another. And they were too miserly to spend 10 cents for the bus fare to come here. So ultimately, they are the losers. I mean, they are the winners. They saved 10 cents. So now, ladies and gentlemen, I will begin this conference with a toast. And the toast has got to be begun with a toast. Here it is, ladies and gentlemen. See this teeny weeny little glass that I've got here? This teeny weeny little glass. See, it's so small that in this teeny weeny little glass, we are going to have a toast. And one glass will be served to all the 170 members gathered together here, right? One sip, 170 sips. What? Excuse me, the butler says that they don't have any wine. I'll get them water instead. What? What? They say the water supply has been shut off because we didn't pay the water bills. Well, that's how it should be with misers. So, ladies and gentlemen, there's nothing in this glass, but we can't afford to let nothing go to waste. So I'll drink it, right? Okay. Now they say there's no toast here, but there has got to be a toast. Butler! Excuse me, there's no butler here. The fact is that I double for the butler. I'm double the butler. So I am the butler. Butler! Yes, sir. Get a toast. Yes, sir. Oh, yes. Here's the toast, ladies, misers and miseries. Here's the toast. Now, all we've got to do is keep it going for 170 bites for each of the delegates here. So the toast to this conference. I'll take the first bite. As a matter of fact, it's so good. Why don't I take the rest of the 170 bites also? Oh, wait a minute. I'm passing it on. Okay. No need to get upset. You see, even your losing your temper has got to be done in a miserly fashion. So, ladies and gentlemen, all the problems of the world can be solved if everybody becomes a miser, conserves all the money he's got, there'll be no financial problems in the whole world. That is our philosophy. And now I'm going to check upon our budget here. But before I check upon the budget, yes, let me check upon the budget. The budget says, ladies and gentlemen, that this is a small computer. We have got a miserly computer, right? We are all multi-billionaires, you see, and we can't afford to waste money. So we got this computer for $10 or $20 at a junk shop. Okay, now, junk shop in Hong Kong. Here it is. Click, click, click. Here's the mouse. Zap it. Now, what do I get here? It says that our budget is zero. Wonderful, wonderful. That's how it should be. Miser's Conference operating on a zero budget. That's better. It's better. But then we could have done better if we had a minus budget going into the red. But so what? Okay, that's it. So we've got a zero budget. Now, if you gentlemen would not mind, I have got to attend a meeting. I've got to attend a meeting somewhere. I don't know where it is. I've got to attend a meeting. It's in my... So I've got this car. You see, I don't want to buy a big car. So we have these miserly cars prepared for all misers. And we all we have to do is put our foot inside. I mean, you can try to get into there, right? So now I've got to go, right? So I've got to go on an urgent business because I have to attend an international conference for misers. What? That's this conference? It shall remain our greatest regret that our president, the greatest miser in the whole world, has not been able to come, and he will never be able to come, because he's spending his entire life in a life imprisonment sentence in jail, you see. He's gone to jail voluntarily for the free food, free boarding and lodging, free exercise, breaking up of rocks, good for the bones, things like that. Everything they say, he's a peanut brain, they say he's a bonehead, they say he's a bird brain, but he is in jail. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, the greatest miser in the world has preferred jail. And every time they try to send him out of the jail, he bonks the jail warden on the head and is sent back again for another 10 years. So, ladies and gentlemen, the greatest miser in the world cannot attend. I'm very sorry to say that. But if we wish to go and meet him, you know, all we've got to do is go outside, find a police officer, and bonk him on the head, and we'll meet him. Stop this conference, everybody. All the misers in this miserly hall are under arrest. This is the Interpol. Not to be confused with Intel Pro, which is the Intel processor. Right? I came in through the windows, but that does not mean I'm the Intel processor. The fact is, ladies and gentlemen, misers and miseries, you're all under arrest by the Interpol. What does the Interpol mean, by the way? Does anyone have any idea? Anyway, you're all under arrest. And this little pistol that I brought, this was to show my appreciation for your miserly efforts. I was going to fire this pistol in the air as a last concluding shot, but we are too miserly to waste bullets. So we have got rubber bullets here. So I'll conclude the concluding part of the arrest by shooting a rubber bullet. This is to conclude the arrest. Now, ladies and gentlemen, now that you're all under arrest, for spreading counterfeit notes. You see, we got a wind of how you misers live. The fact was that you were not spending a single penny from your accounts. You were not releasing a single penny from the bags and bags of money you have got, from the bags and bags of swimming pools into which you dive, bags of dollars into which you dive every morning. So we found out that you are living on the basis of counterfeit notes, counterfeit currency. This is not the International Misers Conference. This is the International Misers, International Monetary Counterfeit Notes Conference. And all of you are under arrest. And to make sure that I do it properly, I've just brought one handcuff to handcuff all of you. And we are taking you to our special miser's prison, where there'll be just one solitary confinement cell for all the members put together. You won't have your bags of money to count daily, but we'll provide you with bags of rocks to pray.